We now come to a very important schedule, and this is important as far as clinical trials is concerned. All of us have heard about the term clinical trials, and to some extent you have also studied it under the various subjects of pharmacology or clinical pharmacy, etc. Clinical trials are those which are carried out on human beings. Those trials that are carried out in animals are called as preclinical trials, whereas trials that are carried out in human beings are called as clinical trials. And any formulation manufacturer who wishes to study the effect of his formulation on human beings should carry out in compliance with Schedule Y, which states the requirements and guidelines for clinical trials, import and manufacture of new drugs. In order to comply with the different requirements for undertaking clinical trials, the manufacturer has to comply with the requirements and guidelines for permission to carry out these clinical trials. The very first step in this involves the application for permission to import or manufacture a new drug for the purpose of undertaking clinical trials. And this application is made in Form 44, and the data that is asked for has to be provided along with the application form. The data that is asked includes chemical and pharmaceutical information, second, animal pharmacology data, animal toxicology data, human clinical pharmacology data if available, and reports of any other studies that have been carried out, as well as regulatory status of that drug in other countries. After all the data is obtained and has been evaluated by the licensing authority, the licensing authority will give the approval for clinical trial. Clinical trial on the new drug shall be initiated only after permission has been granted by the licensing authority under Rule 21B, as well as approval has been obtained from the ethics committee of that organization. Once the approval for clinical trial has been obtained, then it is the responsibility of the sponsor of the clinical trial to see that the laboratory or the hospital in which clinical trial is carried out is following GMP. At the same time, it is very important to note that no deviations from or changes to the protocol should be implemented without prior written approval of the ethics committee. Thus, the ethics committee plays a very important role in providing guidelines as well as monitoring the progress of the clinical trials. Any deviations have to be with permission of the ethics committee as well as the licensing authority, except where it is necessary to eliminate immediate hazards. The different phases of the clinical trial, as you already know, includes phase 1 to phase 4. Phase 1 is also called as the human pharmacology trial, and the objective of these studies carried out in this phase are estimation of safety and tolerability with initial administration of an investigational new drug into humans. Remember, this is a totally new drug that has not been tried out on humans at all, at least in India. Such a drug is being administered for the very first time to human beings. So the very first objective is to estimate whether it is safe and whether it can be tolerated. So phase 1 studies involve estimation of safety and tolerability with initial administration of such a new drug. These studies are usually conducted in healthy volunteers or certain types of patients. In this study, the maximum tolerated dose is calculated. Pharmacokinetics is estimated, pharmacodynamics is calculated, and early measurement of drug activity is carried out. in phase 1. Phase 1 trials should preferably be carried out by investigators trained in clinical pharmacology with access to necessary facilities to closely observe and monitor the subjects. As I told you earlier, the objective of phase 1 trial is to estimate the maximum tolerated dose, to find the pharmacokinetics behavior of the drug, which includes the absorption, distribution, metabolism and elimination of the drug from the body, and to study the pharmacodynamic characteristics of the drug, wherein the plot of drug concentration in plasma as a function of time is graphically drawn and used to calculate further parameters. Another important objective is to measure an early measurement of drug activity. Phase 2 trials, which are called as therapeutic exploratory trials, here the objective is to evaluate the effectiveness of the drug in patients for a particular indication in patients who are suffering from a condition, as well as to determine the short-term side effects and risks associated with the drug. Such a therapeutic exploratory trial is carried out in a very small population of patients, as small as 100 to 300 patients, and these are carried out in a homogeneous group, so either the same sex or the same age group, etc. Studies in phase 2 should be conducted in a group of patients who are selected by a relatively narrow criteria, and thus a relatively homogeneous population is chosen. At the end of the trials, the dose and dosage regimen is established, finalized, and used for carrying out phase 3 trials. In phase 3 trials, which are called as therapeutic confirmatory trials, the primary objective is to demonstrate or confirm the therapeutic benefits that were observed in phase 2 trials. Such a trial is carried out in a larger population, leading up to thousands of patients, and these are heterogeneous. Different groups are included in the study. Such studies provide a basis for marketing approval, and they generate a lot of data that will help the regulatory authorities to decide whether to give approval to market the drug. Building upon the data that is generated in phase 2 and early phase 3, phase 3 also further explores the dose-response relationships, use of drug in wider populations, in different stages of the disease, as well as safety and efficacy of the drug in combination with other drugs. Finally, after carrying out phase 1, 2 and 3 studies and submission of the data to regulatory agencies, the licensing authority reviews the data and gives permission to market the drug. Once the drug reaches the market and is available to a larger population, phase 4 trials are initiated. Because these are initiated after the drug reaches the market, these are also called as post-marketing trials. These are basically studies that have been carried out after the drug has been approved. These trials go beyond the demonstration of the drug's safety, efficacy and dose determination. Sometimes these trials may not be considered necessary at the initial stage, but may be required by the licensing authority for optimizing the drug usage. These studies include determination of drug-drug interaction, dose response, safety studies, mortality studies, epidemiological studies, carcinogenic potential, and teratogenicity potential. Lastly, comes the studies in special populations, which is also carried out along with phase 4 studies or maybe later on. Here, information supporting the use of the drug in children, pregnant women, nursing women, elderly patients, patients with renal or other organ failure, and those on specific chronic medication are carried out. The most important population here is the geriatric population and the pediatric population, which is quite large and in which the studies need to be carried out to establish the safety, efficacy and non-toxic potential of the drug in this population. This slide shows a summary of the clinical trials in brief. The entire process of carrying out the clinical trials has been explained pictorially. As you can see, the very first step is the approval of the protocol for carrying out the clinical studies. For this purpose, application is submitted to the licensing authority and all relevant data is attached to it. Once the data is, once the protocol is approved, then the selection of the team to carry out as well as the premises to carry out the clinical trials is done. Approval process is completed. The volunteers are recruited for the different studies, whether it is phase 1 or 2 or 3. The clinical study is carried out. The data is collated and it is entered into the system. It is processed statistically. Statistical evaluation of data is carried out. And the conclusions are drawn. And finally, the report of the phase 1, 2 and 3 trials is ready and is submitted to the licensing authority, who then grants approval for marketing of the drug. Post marketing of the drug, phase 4 trials is carried out, which is a market survey of the drug after it has reached the market. Subsequently, further down the line, special studies in special population are also carried, and ultimately the entire clinical history of the drug, the clinical data of the drug is generated and is available in the public domain for future reference. So thus, the life of the drug in its clinical phases from 1 to 4 takes anywhere between 5 to 10 years for the data to be generated and to be available. So clinical trials forms a very important part of the life history of the drug and is included, and some rules, regulations and requisitions for this are given in Schedule Y. So any manufacturer wishing to carry out clinical trials of the drug manufactured by them have to necessarily comply with the rules, regulations and provisions as mentioned in Schedule Y, gather the data and submit it to the licensing authority, and this data will decide whether the drug can be launched into the market. Based on the data available, if the drug is found to be safe, effective and non-toxic, then it will be approved for marketing. Once marketed, it will undergo phase 4 clinical studies, special population studies, and all this data will again be submitted to the licensing authority for as a matter of complete records. So with this, the topic of Drugs and Cosmetics Act and rules has been concluded. All the schedules right from A to Y have to be read by you, because as a pharmacist, you need to know the entire set of rules, regulations and requisitions, which is a regulatory requirement, and this will help you in your professional career to understand and perform more efficiently and contribute to the pharmaceutical knowledge domain in a much more and significant manner.